Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The Beatitudes, recited 2,000 years ago, right here on this mountain of Beatitudes, where Jesus preached. And I would say that he recited it as a Jew. This prayer could, in Hebrew, be recited in any synagogue today or at the time. We don't have evidence of this prayer beforehand, but it certainly fits in theologically and style-wise with every other Jewish prayer. In fact, the word that he chose, blessed, it's not just blessed as it's translated in English. There really is no English word for translation. In Hebrew, there are two words. One is blessed, like we say in our blessings, blessed art thou, O Lord, our God, King of the universe, and that word is baruch. But there's another word that is used especially in Psalms, which is the word that I believe Jesus used and intended, and that's ashrei. Blessed meaning you are abundant. Osher meaning wealth in Hebrew. You are blessed in the sense that God will bestow upon you that abundance of blessing. And so from this very important site, 2,000 years ago, a very important message was delivered for Christians and for Jews alike.
To learn more about how you can be a blessing to Israel and the work of the International Fellowship of Christians and Jews, call the fellowship at the number on the screen or go to ifcj.org. Shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael.